Good afternoon. I've just met with the Vice President, Secretary Blinken, Secretary Austin, National Security Advisor Sullivan, and other members of the National Security Leadership Team, the Situation Room, to discuss our ongoing efforts to evacuate American citizens, third country civilians, Afghan allies, and vulnerable Afghans. And I want to provide the American people with a brief update on the situation in Afghanistan. Since I spoke to you on Monday, we've made significant progress. We've secured the airport, enabling flights to resume, not just military flights, but civilian charters and from other countries, and the NGOs taking out civilians and vulnerable Afghanis. And now we have almost 6,000 troops on the ground, including the 82nd Airborne, providing runway security, the Army 10th Mountain Division standing guard around the airport, and the 24th Marine Expeditionary Unit assisting the civilian departure. This is one of the largest, most difficult airlifts in history, and the only country in the world capable of projecting this much power on the far side of the world with this degree of precision is the United States of America. We've already evacuated more than 18,000 people since July and approximately 13,000 since our military airlift began on August the 14th. Thousands more have been evacuated on private charter flights facilitated by the U.S. government. These numbers include American citizens and permanent residents, as well as their families. It includes SIV applicants and their families, those Afghans who have worked alongside us, served alongside of us, gone into combat with us, and provided invaluable assistance to us, such as translators and interpreters. The United States stands by its commitment that we've made to these people, and includes other vulnerable Afghans, such as women leaders and journalists. In fact, working in close coordination with the management of the New York Times, the Washington Post, and the Wall Street Journal, we have successfully evacuated all 204 of their employees in Afghanistan on U.S. military aircraft earlier this week. We've established the flow of flights, and we've increased the number of people we're moving out of the country. We paused flights in Kabul a few hours this morning to make sure we could process the arriving evacuees at the transit points. But our commander in Kabul has already given the order for outbound flights to resume. Even with the pause, we've moved out 5,700 evacuees yesterday. And we're working on a variety to verify that number. The Americans are still in country as we work on this, because we're not — don't have the exact number of people who are Americans are there. And those who may have come home to the United States, we want to get a strong number as to exactly how many people are there, how many American citizens, and where they are. Just yesterday, among the many Americans we evacuated, there were 169 Americans who got over the wall into the airport using military assets. We're also facilitating flights for our allies and our partners, and working in close operational coordination with NATO on this evacuation.